Welcome to the Step Up Podcast. Insights from experts to step up your business, your life, and your wealth. Step Up is provided by Agency Bloom, today's number one superhero for wholesale services to digital agencies. Get ready to propel your business from ordinary to extraordinary. Here's your host, Matt Coffey.
Okay, welcome listener or watcher of the Step Up Show. My name's Matt Coffey. Hey, wanted to talk today about a little bit different of a tact that we were working on. We want to bring in some of the environments that today that we work with customers and parallel them to really what we're talking about in the Agency Bloom Step Up world about correlating technology and anticipation and connections all together into making sense of really working in this digital agency space, and what things can inspire you to grow and become more of a person who evangelizes technology. So let's take a step back and look at technology before we get into talking about how this can affect how you think and how you talk to potentially even a customer base, because this is really where we want to start to think about why people make decisions and what makes a difference in your world and how to think about how to grow your business. Because at the end of the day, Step Up is really about stepping up mentally, stepping up your business, and stepping up your ability to help others. So the thought process here is that 100 years ago, in 1915, you have to think about how far we've come and how fast things are. In 1915, there were no radios yet. Because what had happened was that even the amateur radio operators of the day had to stop using their radios because of World War I. So they were actually, all the radios were confiscated so that it wouldn't interfere with any of the, you know, naval and army messaging from the radio. And at that point, there really wasn't even voice over the radio. Very unlikely we'd find actually voice broadcast. So we were at the point in 1915 where there's no radio, really not a lot of electricity throughout the United States. And so now fast forward and come to the point where we're 20 years ago. So 1995, Windows 95 had just come out. Most people weren't even on the internet. So they weren't even now connected. So we would look at the mass population. There was no broadband. It was all dial-up. And now come to 2015 or 2015, you get pissed off when you can't get Wi-Fi on your airplane. So, you know, I think the concept of how fast things are really going correlates to the discussions that we have with some of our clients and correlates to your life and your business about how do we grow faster? How do we get a better linchpin into the next level? So one of the challenges that we find is that there's abundance thinking, there's the mentality of that, and then there's the exponential capabilities. Now, I just went through an example of the exponential growth of what's going on in really in our world, how fast things are going. Now, think about this. When we talk to customers, when I talk to customers in our business, we run into roadblocks sometimes where we find customers who are romantic about what they have. So they don't want to leave their current e-commerce platform or their current website because it's good enough and it works, and you know, yes, we know we should do something, but, you know, it's just too much to mentally move myself through that process. This is where this abundance strategy really needs to come into the fold, because what as an agency or as a person who now needs to talk to customers at this level, you need to make sure that you engage them in the exponential discussion about having the step back to say, look, you know you need to do this stuff. It's exponentially moving forward in a marketing standpoint as fast as you possibly could think, because the microchip has really changed how things have happened since right around, obviously, the 1950s or so when it was invented. But now the compression of how many things are happening in the world with so many people with advantages globally, that you need to really think about how to get people to not get into their romantic feelings about what they have and think about the future of what's going to happen. Now, in adapting this, in adapting the strategy, you really have to think about the market loss if you don't take advantage of the things that are going on now, the tools and the things that are going to be available to you and the people who are available to you to help evangelize the ability to make these tools work. Now, that comes back to the whole thing of why we try and talk to other agencies like yourself or a listener who's on board, who may be an entrepreneur, who needs to think about confidence and what you like to do. So you may be a web designer, you may be somebody who's an entrepreneur who likes to do marketing, but it's really up to you to also think about evangelizing the strategies from a perspective of becoming a hero for your client. Because most clients don't understand any of this because it's just not in their area of expertise. It's not really up to them to go and figure out how things work in a digital marketing space. But we know the advances and we know how quickly things are moving forward. To not take advantage of these advances and not be the hero for a customer really is a thing that is a huge problem and a huge confidence issue, I think, for most smaller agencies or digital agencies that have not had the experience of bringing in that thought process when they talk to a client. Confidence itself is generated from knowledge, and it's generated from a future thing that's going to happen that's a positive result. When you're going into the future, when you're thinking about the future, you need to think about the reason why you're in front of a customer or the reason why you're in front of this person is the connection. And to basically say to the customer, the reason why I'm here is that it's for our best both future endeavors. So you're connecting with me, Mr. Customer. I'm connecting with you. There is a future benefit to be advantaged right between the two of our relationships. Now, the reason why I think a lot of people get stuck into the, let's say, components and explaining money and explaining pricing is that they're not taking advantage of looking at the future results and the connection that's being made. So the customer is getting an advantage because they don't have the ability to connect with someone who is right now, let's say before an event or a sale is made, they're not able to take advantage of the technology and the tools. You're bringing that in. So it's not necessarily just thinking about what you're going to do physically for them as in a digital marketing space, creating a website, doing it. It is the future advantage of having you as the connection. And that's the confidence booster you have to think about when you go and see a client. The only thing you should think about is the prepared future that you're going to be creating for the customer. Not the advantage of one phone call more than the last guy, not the advantage of having better rankings or a better looking website, but the advanced future. Now this comes back to the whole thought about money. So money is really the advancement of what you and I really think about, which is that, oh, if we just had more money, if we just made this amount of money, things would be better. But in reality, what it is, it's the connections you make. So you have to be very careful about how you proceed in your business and how you proceed in your life to the people you're going to connect with, because the connections you're going to make are going to pull your future right with you. So the better you make connections, the more quality connections you make to more quality people, whether they're clients, vendors, or people of influence, that's what's really going to pull you forward. And you know what? That's really money. The relationship, the legacy of your relationships that you make with other people is really your wealth. So I hope this helps. We'll catch you in the next episode.
Thanks so much for listening to today's episode of the Step Up Podcast with your host, Matt Coffey. We'll see you next time.